teams changing ends. Kettering will be kicking towards the Tin Hat, and Paul White going down towards the Brian Martin's end. Kettering Town fans moving to the Tin Hat. They normally like playing there in the second half.
Yeah,
but
it's not a surprise to see the team winning the toss, changing ends today. You've got to think about the win. Kettering are going to have the win behind them in this first half. So it'll be interesting to see just how that comes into play, whether it's actually an advantage or a disadvantage. We'll see that as we go along.
Back to Rasulu on that far side. Good work there from Banbury. They go forward. Ichifano does well here. He's inside the penalty area. Can he come through? Beats one, beats two. It comes off at Stanley, cleared by Richens. That only goes towards Nash, though. Thought about a shot. Doesn't. It's in fact that Rasulu's now got the ball. On the far side there is Henderson. Henderson flicks it through to Shamsi. Shamsi plays it. Comes the back off for Ichifano. And eventually Kelly manages to get the ball away. Just hooks it anywhere as the wind takes it. And that's going to be a throw-in to Banbury. But he's featured prominently in this game so far. He's got the ball from the throw-in as Hotter. Down by the corner flag. Being pursued by Solkin. Comes off Odiambo to Shamsi, but he does well there. Plays it back to Nash. Nash back to Shamsi. Might try a shot. Comes inside. He's inside the penalty area. Does a little flick. Cries of handball, but cleared by Stanley. And that goes out again. Holman can't keep that in. Another throw in to Banbury, who are applying the pressure on Harding with the goal kick. And this might be reaching us again. It goes straight into the Kettering dugout from that kick. Dan Willis nonchalantly puts the ball back to Kelly. From that throw in, he finds Richens. Back to Stanley under pressure. And that's a Blimey. Filthy foul there from Hotter. And the Kettering fans are going mad here as the players are. And there's a bit of argy-bargy here between Wise and Solkin. It was a terrible two-footed tackle. And the number five, Wise, is hysterical. He should calm down. Talis is going to produce what colour card, John?
Red.
Yeah. Red! He's gone, and rightly so. No argument there.
Absolutely no argument.
The former Kettering player goes off, and all the players now run over towards the referee and linesman, but the decision has been made. And it is the number 10, Ichifano, once again. It is in fact Rasso with the ball. Back to Rasso in the centre of the park. Plays it out to Taylor on the far side. Taylor advancing. Doing well there. He finds Award. Wasn't that a ban for the 1980s, Aswad? cut out by Stanley. Now Holman's
chase
underneath
that.
This. It's
going
to get through to Wise. Heads it back to keeper. Out comes Honus. Honus is through. Open goal.
Goal.
And goal. Awful back pass by Banbury. Intercepted by Honus. And just 3 minutes after the sending off, Rhys Honus puts the Poppies 1-0 ahead.
Yeah, really good ball over the top. You could see Honus anticipating that Wise was going to head it back. He did head it back. He didn't get enough on it. Round the keeper he goes, rolls it in. It's been a useful 3 minutes for Kettering. Banbury down to 10 men, and now they've gifted them the opening goal. Well done, Rhys Honus. He anticipated it. Round the keeper, cool as you like from a narrow angle. And they're 1-0 up.
If you are listening abroad in a hotter climate, you lucky devils. Normally we have Americans, Australians and New Zealanders, Kenyans all listening in. I bet you're not
jealous.
The North
face. We are not jealous whatsoever.
Not so ever. I'd rather be up here freezing my things off.
Yeah, as we hold onto this scaffolding and try to make sure we don't fall off.
And that is the order of the day, isn't it? The ball's put forward towards Holman. Holman's got nobody with him on the edge of the penalty area. Storer and Solkin in there. So back towards Solkin, back post, headed out. There's Storer underneath. Storer
yes.
Fires. And he plants it back hard in 2-0.
Absolutely magnificent. Gary Storer. What a goal. Brilliant work from Holman. Lovely ball over the top. Holman picks up, crossed it over. Half cleared by the header. Solkin was there challenging for it. And it dropped perfectly for him, but he's absolutely cracked it on the volley. Bottom corner. Thank you very much. 2-0.
Well, he always scores one cracking goal a season. Last season he did a weave through three players and hooked it by the goalkeeper. That though, the volley, fantastic goal. Again, you can see that on our highlights later in the week. Stanley then advancing for Kettering into the Banbury half, loses the ball, and it is Ichifano, who's just been talking about, who retrieves it, gets it to Nash. Nash, he finds the number 12, Awad. He's going forward, might try a long range shot. He's got three or four options here. Gets the ball to Shamsi. Shamsi fires one in, and it comes offside? Off the no? number 10, and yeah, he's offside.
Yeah,
Ichifano offside, gets the touch from Awad. Yeah.
He didn't and need to touch it, did he?
Didn't need to touch it. It had beaten Paul White, but it came in. And the flag went up for offside. Referee Tallis is going over to Scott Postin to just check this. If it had left it alone, that would have beaten Paul White. But Ichifano desperately got a touch to it. And it has been disallowed for offside. It is Kelly, though, with it. Gets it to Meikle, back to Kelly, to Meikle. Meikle on the outside of the penalty, puts the ball in towards the back post. There is Sulkin. Sulkin fires one in, 3-0.
Oh no, he's done it again.
The Kettering Angel, his 114th goal for the Poppies in his 560th appearance, 3-0.
Sulkin again. Meikle's cross, I think it was, wasn't it? Lyndon Meikle's crossed it over. It's been down, and Sulkin has just seized on the loose ball all the time in the world. Left foot, bottom corner, 3-0. It's a long way back for Banbury now.
Meikle trying to find Honus, doesn't get there. It spoons off a Banbury player towards Shamsi. Shamsi robbed though by Meikle. Meikle then robbed by Shamsi. Shamsi comes away with the ball. He's got nobody at the moment. He's got Kelly in front of him. Goes left foot. He puts the ball through towards Ichifano, and Paul White comes out down at his 6-yard box and takes the ball away from Ichifano.
For them, it's all about trying to seize on any mistakes that Kettering make.
Well, another mistake there from Wise has found Meikle in the centre pot. Puts the ball through towards Honus. Honus heads it back header. And unlucky there. He heads it only towards Richens, who's marched up there, gets it to Honus. Honus back to Storer. And he's trying to find Honus, but Taylor hooks the ball towards Kelly Evans, who heads it high towards Sulkin. Sulkin wins that towards Storer, traps it on his beard. He gets it to Rich and squares it on the far side now to Kelly. Kelly with a bit of space. He's got Meikle on his right-hand side. Here comes Meikle in his penalty area. Comes in through here. Back post, there's Honus. Honus takes his time. Might try a shot.
Oh, any
Picked
chance.
It through to Storer. Storer, Mike can't shoot. Blocked out of it. Back to Meikle. Meikle still in the penalty area. Puts a lazy little ball through, and it finds Harding. Shamsi should have scored. In fact, his ball was going into the net until Ichifano got a touch to it. But from that, it is Honus with it. He's coming inside the penalty area, flicks it on the outside to Kelly Evans. Kelly Evans puts a high ball in, goalkeeper hard underneath it. There's Sulkin. Sulkin gets it. It comes off Wise. Sulkin!
Oh!
And on the second attempt there, it just goes over. Now, Kelly with a bit of space on the far side. He has Adwar in front of him. Plays it back to Meikle. Meikle takes a touch, comes inside the centre of the park, puts a long ball through towards Holman, chests it towards Kelly Evans inside the penalty area. Kelly Evans going to go outside, does so. In comes the ball here, should be a goal.
Oh.
And it is cut out by the number 18, Rasso. Paul White then towards Holman, beaten to it by Henderson. Richens could only find Rasso. He plays a slight ball over the other side to Casaboni. Casaboni, strong, powerful, tries a shot that goes high and wide, goes on to pitch 5 here at Latimer Park. Rasso with the ball just off the boundary, flicks it through to Taylor. Taylor puts the ball in here, header. Free header
dangerous,
here.
Dangerous.
In comes Nash.
Good block.
Good block by Stanley, and that could have gone in. In comes the 14. It was Henderson, but to Rasso. Rasso, good pressure here from the away team, the Puritans. It's the number 12, Adwal, with the ball. He's done well. Got it into penalty area. Ichifano gets it back to Aswad. And he goes down. And that should be a Kettering Town goal kick. It is. Richens in the centre of the park. He sprays it out wide to Gary Storer by the burger van, who's not having a burger, by the way, but he's by the burger van. He got the advancing Kelly. Kelly now comes in, cuts inside. Lovely work there to Holman. Holman inside the penalty area, plays in a shot, and it goes high and wide of Harding's goal. There's Finch, beaten to it by Kelly Evans. Meikle has the ball.
Lovely work there from
Meikle. Silky skills there in difficult conditions. He's found Storer. Storer plays the ball through to Honus on the far side. Honus with a bit of space. Mike comes in, tries a shot. No, he doesn't. Does now. Comes a ricochet. Here comes Holman. Holman, flag goes
up. He's offside.
And he's offside anyway, but it's blocked flag goes up as Holman and Kelly Evans were going to pounce. And James Brighton is back on this field for the first time in 16 months. And off comes Lyndon Meikle for Ben Bradshaw. So Sulkin gets the ball to Honus. Honus being pressurized. Don't have to spell there. Honus, can he carry on there? He's on his own. He's got in.
Come on.
Now he's got Holm with him. He's inside the penalty area. Goes outside it by the 14 Henderson. But in comes Brighton. Corner comes in. Swinging corner. Ooh. Headed on there. There's Toseland. Toseland fires one in. And that's more akin to Franklin's Gardens than it is to Latimer Park. It goes over. Yeah, very
made
good
that
addition.
Right back area of his own, doesn't he?
As a small player, he leaps very high, doesn't he? And gets a lot of headers in there. So man of the match is Gary Storer. There was 760 here at Latimer Park. At the moment, it's 3-0 as Rasu comes inside, tries a long-range shot. It comes off the post and bounces out. Paul White going ballistic at his defence. It hit the post, came out, and no Banbury player could actually follow it up. It would have been disastrous. And there goes the whistle. That was the last action of the half, and it could have resulted in a goal, but it didn't. Paul White keeps another clean sheet. Kettering win by 3-0. They go 11 points clear now at the top of the table. Goals came from Brett Sulkin, Gary Storer, and the opener from Rhys Honus. And it was a very, very professional performance in very difficult conditions, John Dunham, that Kettering have come out 3-0 winners.
Terrific afternoon for Kettering. Bounce back in style, given a helping hand by the red card in the first half, deserved in my opinion, given a helping hand by the opening goal, but from then on it was one-way traffic.